the latest about breast cancer news and the correlation of what we eat may be, well, it could either enhance the risk of getting breast cancer or help to keep it at bay. Do you want to start with that?
I certainly do. What you're alluding to is a article published in the Journal of the National Cancer Institute looking at fruit and vegetable consumption and whether it could lower the risk of breast cancer in general. Now, this is what we call a cohort study, meaning that there have been other groups, multiple different groups. In fact, in this situation, there are 20 different cohort groups who have been studied, Lisa, prospectively, followed anywhere from 11 to 20 years. And in this particular sort of amalgamated report, if you will, there are over 900,000 women who have been followed. And so what the researchers were doing, and they have in these cohort groups, they have data, you know, dietary data, weight data, blood pressure data. I mean, just all sorts of things that they have. And so there's been this discussion for some period of time that if we increase vegetables and fruit in our diet, would it lower the overall risk of breast cancer? And from this particular report, the answer is in what's called estrogen receptor positive breast cancers, which is the majority of breast cancers. The answer is no, doesn't seem to have an impact. But what's interesting and what's important about this study is that in estrogen receptor negative breast cancers, in other words, those that have no hormone sensitivity, if you will, that it does have an impact on lowering the risk and incidence of estrogen receptor negative breast cancer.
This is such important information, especially those who were diagnosed with the estrogen receptive negative versus positive, because you always hear after you've had your surgery and you've had your mastectomy or your lumpectomy, if you are ER negative, it's kind of like, okay, what else can I do? And so I think the fact that what we eat can also keep it at bay for the people who are ER negative, that's terrific. If you're ER positive, then, okay, you have your tamoxifen and like we've talked about with the radiation. But this is terrific. Are there certain foods? I mean, I've heard spinach, broccoli, asparagus. Have you heard any others for those who were diagnosed with the estrogen receptive negative?
Well, first of all, at least in this report, there's not a breakdown specifically in the types of vegetables. The what's called the subset analysis, it actually ends up that the impact of vegetables is greater than fruits. Now, Lisa, I think we need to put all this in perspective. One of the things that we know is that breast cancer is more common in industrialized societies. So what do we have in general in industrialized societies? We have refined foods. We have a higher incidence of obesity. We're probably consuming less of the desirable foods, if you will. When I read this, I sort of smiled to myself and said, remember what Mom always said, eat your vegetables.
It's so true. Oh, I know. And make sure that they're fresh if you can, right?
absolutely correct. Now, and so one of the things that, this reminds me of, is that we've got our good friends at the University of Arizona and the Integrative Medicine Department, and we've had them on Breast Cancer Answers in the past. This would be a wonderful invite the expert to dissect this kind of study more. One of the things that we know from Victoria Mays and the others at the University of Arizona is we want to lower inflammation in our body. And there's been a fair amount of research and work done, especially by the folks at Arizona and elsewhere, that lowering inflammation has a positive effect not only on our good health, but may also lower the risk of cancer in general. Or in other words, put it the other way around, that inflammation in our body created by an inflammation type diet, if you will, could increase the incidence of cancer. And this is true for men with prostate cancer as well as women with breast cancer. And so dissecting down, I mean, you really ask a good question about what we can do dietary-wise to not only keep cancer at a bay, but also once we're diagnosed, how do we help ourselves? Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.